I want kids to have a rich, meaningful, inquiry-based education in science so that they can go out and they can be the problem solvers for the world.
You have to ignite the enthusiasm of students, that you can turn them on to the subject that you're teaching, and that they can develop a deep passion for what they're learning.
We're doing our best to get students into the 21st century and engaged in 21st century skills, as well as, you know, having them engaged in the appropriate mathematics and science content for their grade level or subject.
With this age of technology and the fact that students are used to instant gratification, that they want immediate feedback, we can't teach them the way we were once taught.
Well, Gizmos is different because of the animation and because it kind of comes to life, how they can really see it because of the 3D nature of it, and they actually see the balance there and they see how what you do to one side, you do to the other side. The things I say in my applications, they can see it in Gizmo.
The design of Gizmos allows students to manipulate variables and to work in an environment that students are very comfortable in.
It's very data-oriented, very data-driven. That's what the lab should be. It expands on what I can do in class.
When the kids saw the atoms actually being moved and taken away and what that was doing to the coefficient of the compound, she said it was like light bulbs going on all over in the room.
I was able to use Element Builder with my special needs kids in one aspect, then I was able to use it with my rich kids a totally different direction.
The students establish their accounts in class, and once they've established their accounts, I tell them they can access Gizmos from anywhere.
The fact that a student can sit by themselves and can actually work ahead, and they can use the Gizmos as an exploration tool. That's totally different. All of those things are just so powerful, all wrapped up into one.
It's amazing how many have been accessing it from home. To me, that says success.
Teachers have told me the confidence level in this specific population has risen. Their assessments, they've increased their testing scores, their performance assessments.
Proud to say that last year in my double block algebra class, which is the weakest algebra students we have in the school, got 100% to pass the SOL. Also, I taught summer school last year, and in summer school, those are kids that were unsuccessful during the school year and taking it for the second time, and I also got 100%.
I have to attribute it to all the things that we're doing, but especially the technology as a really, really good tool.
I saw the Gizmos and said, wow, this is what I want.